with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who have prepared fitting helps for us in our weakness, grant, we pray, that we may receive their healing effects with joy and reflect them in a holy way of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The wicked said among themselves, thinking not aright, let us beset the just one, because he is obnoxious to us. He sets himself against our doings, reproaches us for transgressions of the law, and charges us with violations of our training. He professes to have knowledge of God and styles himself a child of the Lord. To us, he is the censure of our thoughts. Merely to see him is a hardship for us. Because his life is not like that of others, and different are his ways, he judges us debased. He holds aloof from our paths as from things impure. He calls blessed the destiny of the just and boasts that God is his Father. Let us see whether his words be true. Let us find out what will happen to him. For if the just one be the Son of God, he will defend him and deliver him from the hand of his foes. With revilement and torture, let us put him to the test, that we may have proof of his gentleness and try his patience. Let us condemn him to a shameful death, for according to his own words, God will take care of him. These were their thoughts, but they erred, for their wickedness blinded them, and they knew not the hidden counsels of God. Neither did they count on a recompense of holiness, nor discern the innocent soul's reward. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is close to the brokenhearted. The Lord confronts the evildoers to destroy remembrance of them from the earth. When the just cry out, the Lord hears them, from all their distress, he rescues them. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and those who are crushed in spirit he saves. Many are the troubles of the just man, but out of them all the Lord delivers him.
The Lord is close to the brokenhearted.
He watches over all his bones. Not one of them shall be broken. The Lord redeems the lives of his servants. No one incurs guilt who takes refuge in him. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted.
He himself also went up, not openly, but as it were in secret. Some of the inhabitants of Jerusalem said, "Is he not the one they are trying to kill? And look, he is speaking openly, and they say nothing to him. Could the authorities have realized that he is the Christ? But we know where he is from. When the Christ comes, no one will know where he is from." So Jesus cried out in the temple area as he was teaching and said, "You know me and also know where I am from. Yet I did not come on my own, but the one who sent me, whom you do not know, is true. I know him because I am from him, and he sent me." So they tried to arrest him, but no one laid a hand upon him, because his hour had not yet come. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When I was a boy, I used to kind of be filled with fear as to how on earth I would know what God was calling me to do in my life. I'd never really heard the voice of God, and I always expected it, but it never came. At a certain point, there was this fear, what if I never hear his voice? What if he never actually calls me? Or what if he calls me and I miss it? This was kind of a reoccurring fear when I was younger. And then as I got older, I suddenly realized that the voice of God, or how God speaks and communicates to us, is not at all as I expected it to be. I expected something foreign, something set apart, something clear and vocal. And what I actually encountered was something familiar, something quiet, something that actually I had heard my whole life, but I didn't know that it was God. This is what we're reminded of in the gospel today, the familiarity of the Lord. Jesus is rejected by many of the Jews because they knew him. They knew where he was from. He was from Nazareth. And so they said, "Surely this can't be God." They shrugged him off, and even more, they hated him. And they even tried to kill him. We're reminded today that God is familiar. He speaks in the depths of our hearts every day. And we cannot reject him. In this time of being stuck at home, I think many of us, or many of you probably, have amended your Lenten practices, thinking, "Gosh, if I'm going to be at home with my kids and my family, there's no way I'm giving up TV for the rest of Lent." I do still encourage, that's understandable, I do still encourage, though, to cultivate that time of silence where we continue to listen for the Lord. We listen for that familiar voice. We need to continue to get to know him. And we're reminded today that he is familiar. We stand now and offer our prayers and petition to our Heavenly Father.
We pray this day for missionaries. May the Lord strengthen them in their zeal to spread the gospel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for policy and lawmakers. May the Holy Spirit inspire them in passing laws protecting all life from conception to natural death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those persecuted for righteousness' sake. May God bless them with courage and perseverance. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our family of faith gathered as it were. May the Lord bless us in our Lenten efforts of prayer, fasting, and almsgiving. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the intentions of this Mass, my intention for Donald Hirsch, Father Jordan's intention, a request for a prayer for all the souls in purgatory, that our prayers and the prayers we all hold in our hearts may reach the ear of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for the faithful departed. In a particular way, I ask a prayer this day for my Uncle Jack, who passed away yesterday. May all who have passed rest in paradise with the angels and the saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear these and all our prayers spoken aloud and in the silence of our hearts. hearts, for we make them through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May this sacrifice, Almighty God, cleanse us by its mighty power and lead us to approach its source with ever greater purity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through bodily fasting you restrain our faults, raise up our minds, and bestow both virtue and its rewards through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
History.
giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jerome, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a gesture or sign of peace. together we make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus,
I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart.
I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you.
Never permit me to be separated from you.
Amen. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as we pass from old to new, so with former ways left behind, we may be renewed in holiness of mind through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Just a few announcements this morning for our parish communities, St. Eugene and St. Monica. We will attempt again tomorrow morning to offer some opportunity for confessions. The drive-through method we used last week in the parking lot at St. Monica Parish. You'll see parking cones and allow proper distance in all the circumstances, both between you and the priest and between the car ahead of you and yourselves. We have uploaded Stations of the Cross, a version that included the Stations from St. Eugene, and we are uploading today a version that has both St. Eugene and St. Monica Stations. So please do on this Friday of Lent take advantage of that. Today's Mysteries of the Rosary would be the Sorrowful. Those are uploaded to my YouTube channel. Just go to YouTube and search for Father Paul Hartman or Paul Hartman, and you'll see my picture. And then in that library, you'll see a version you can pray along with the Sorrowful Mysteries if you're not practiced in that. And then we'll do a third episode of our as yet to be named podcast. I think we're going to try and choose the name today. The votes have been coming in. So stay tuned for that. Hopefully that'll be up later this afternoon or this evening. Two outreach efforts. We are at both parishes, St. Eugene and St. Monica, going to again seek to collect food, canned and dry goods for the food pantries that are in great need right now. Also hygiene products. If you have the small, you know, soaps and shampoos and whatnot, those are greatly needed in the from the pantries. Both parishes would like to do this on Sunday from noon to 1 p.m. Noon to 1 p.m. this Sunday, the main parking lot of both parishes, either parish, just pull up and either, you know, they'll have it set up and they'll give you instructions. You can step out and place everything in a box or pop your trunk and someone will take it out just to minimize the contact between people, respecting the social distancing. And as always, my reminder to reach out to the homebound and the elderly and the vulnerable. A particular way I have on my mind, spoke to my cousin, and I mentioned in the petitions my uncle passing away, and where they live in New Jersey, they won't be allowed to even have a funeral or to be at the burial. So this is a very trying time. Father Jordan and I did a funeral this week with small groups, and we anticipate more of this coming up. Please pray for those families. While it is a corporal work of mercy to bury the dead, it is certainly a sad moment when family can't gather the way it should. So pray for those families who are experiencing loss in these days. Do make the most of this Lenten day.
Wonderful to pray with you this morning. We hope that you have a wonderful day. And today we remember that when we're searching for God, searching for the voice of the Lord, not to be surprised when we discover that it's very familiar. Bow down for the blessing. Look upon your servants, O Lord, and in your goodness protect with heavenly assistance those who trust in your mercy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.